بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. In the name of Allah, the most beneficent, the most merciful, all praise is due to Allah, the Lord of all that exists. May Allah صلاة and salam be upon our Prophet Muhammad, his family and all of his noble companions and those who follow on their path until the day of resurrection. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Hud, Prophet Hud عليه السلام, to his nation عاد. I will write the name. Hud was sent we found that alhamdulillah there are some brothers and sisters I was informed last night they cut and paste the information of the durus and they compile it in a special file and they study it. And alhamdulillah, this is very, very useful. Hud alayhi salam was sent to his people, known as Ad. And the Ad people who lived in a place known as Al-Ahqaf, which is a desert area of South Yemen known as Hadramaut. Yemen. This happened when they became very arrogant and their evil was spreading, and they said their famous statement which Allah related in the Quran in chapter 41 verse 15. Who's going to help inshallah with the verses? But a small kindness, Jazakallah khair, if you can. Abu Maher, you have something, please. Was a hot mic. Abu Mahad, do you want the mic? Okay. So, brother, a small kindness. Chapter 41, verse 15, when they said, من أشد منا قوة. Who is more stronger than us? Chapter 41, verse 15. More kindness, you're going to take that. So who is mightier than us in strength? That's it. Ad. As for Ad, they were arrogant in the land. فَأَمَّا عَادٌ فَاسْتَكْبَرُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ بِغَيْرِ الْحَقِّ without right. وَقَالُوا مَنْ أَشَدُّ مِنَّا قُوَّةً. And they said, who is mightier than us in strength? This is also an addition of their belying the messengers and also setting up rivals with Allah in worship. So Allah sent him to them, calling them to worship none but Allah and to admonish them against their shirk and against their arrogance, calling them in every possible way, reminding them about the favors Allah bestowed upon them from this life and the strength that he had given them. So they rejected his call and were filled with false pride. Yes, there is voice. And they said, as in chapter 11 verse 53, and this chapter 11 carries the name of Surah Hud, chapter 11. It carries the name of Prophet Hud, chapter Hud. So they said, يَا هُودُ مَا جِئْتَنَا بِبَيِّنَةٍ. Hud 53, they said, chapter 11:53, O Hud, no evidence have you brought us, and we shall not leave our gods for your mere saying. and we are not believers in you. And they are lying because in the hadith reported by Imam al-Bukhari, we know that every prophet except that Allah had given him, bestowed upon him from the verses, which are clear verses. So they are really lying. If only the evidence of the messengers was in the deen they are proclaiming, and the message that they are proclaiming, then that by itself is suffice. And from the signs that Allah bestowed upon Hud, alaykum salam, rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh, is that he was standing by his own, by himself, in his da'wah and in his proclamation. And that's why they really threatened him with their gods, that if you don't cease, something will occur to you, meaning something from their gods will occur to him. وَإِلَىٰ عَادٍ أَخَاهُمْ هُودَ قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ اعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ مَا لَكُمْ مِنْ إِلَٰهٍ غَيْرُ إِنْ كُنْتُمْ مُفْتَرُونَ إِلَّا مُفْتَرُونَ. And to the Aad people, we send their brotherhood. He said, O my people, worship Allah, you have no other god but him, certainly you do nothing but invent lies. O my people, I ask of you no reward. And this is the case of all the messengers. They don't ask for any reward from the people they call. يا قوم لا أسألكم عليه أجرا إن أجري إلا على الله الذي فطرني أفلا تعقلون. My reward is only from the one who created me. Will you not then understand? And he admonished them further by saying, ويا قوم استغفروا ربكم ثم توبوا إليه. And all my people, ask forgiveness of your Lord and then repent to him. يرسل السماء عليكم مدرارا ويزدكم قوة إلى قوتكم ولا تتولوا مجرمين. عليكم السلام ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. And he will send you from the sky abundant rain if you believe, and add strength to your strength, so don't turn away as disbelievers and criminals. So what did they say? They said that you don't have an evidence. قالوا يا هود ما جئتنا ببينة. No evidence you have brought us, and we shall not leave our gods for your mere saying, and we are not believers in you. So what did then they say also? إن تقولوا, and this is the evidence, إن تقولوا إلا تراك بعض آلهتنا بسوء. And that we say is that some of our gods have seized you with evil madness. Look at this, they are threatening him. He said, قال إني أشهد الله واشهدوا أني بريء مما تشركون. I call Allah to witness and bear you witness that I am free from that which you ascribe as partners in worship. Yes. So plot against me, all of you, and give me respite. Allahu Akbar. So this is one of the special things about Hud alayhi salam. He was standing alone vis-a-vis his people. So he challenged them and openly challenged them. So plot against me, all of you, and give me no respite. إني توكلت على الله ربي وربكم. I put my trust in Allah, my Lord and your Lord. ما من دابة إلا هو آخذ بناصيتها إن ربي على صراط مستقيم. There is not a moving, living creature, but he has the grasp of its forelock, Allah. Verily my Lord is on the straight path. So they couldn't do any harm to him. And this is one of the great ayahs or signs or miracles of that Allah had bestowed upon Hud alayhi salam. So they turned away from him. He warned them against a coming torment, and that came in the horizon, and at times they were in distress and they were in much for rain. So when they saw clouds, so-called, appearing in their eyes, these were clouds that appeared in the horizon, so they felt happy and they said, if you go to Surah Al-Ahqaf, chapter 46, Brother Small Kindness, chapter 46. هذا عارض ممطرنا. Chapter 46 verse 24. Then when they saw it as a dense cloud, that's it. فلما رأوه عارضا مستقبل أوديتهم قالوا هذا عارض ممطرنا. They said this is a cloud bringing us rain. بل هو ما استعجلتم به ريح فيها عذاب أليم. Nay, but it is that torment which you were asking to be hastened, a wind wherein is a painful torment. You know, they challenged him in the beginning. They said, فأتنا بما تعدنا إن كنت من الصادقين. Bring us that which you threaten us with if you are one of the truthful. And that came. A wind wherein is a painful torment. تدمر كل شيء بأمر ربها. Destroying everything that it will pass upon by the command of its Lord. فأصبحوا لا يرى إلا مساكنهم كذلك نجزي القوم المجرمين. So they became such that nothing could be seen except their dwelling, and thus we recompense the people who are polytheists, disbelievers and sinners. And as Allah spoke about it in chapter 69 verse 7 in Surah Al-Haqqa, سخرها عليهم سبع ليال وثمانية أيام حسوما فترى القوم فيها صرعى كأنهم أعجاز نخل خاوية. Which Allah imposed on them, meaning the wind, for 7 nights and 8 days in succession, so that you could see men lying overthrown, destroyed as if they were hollow trunks of date palms. فَهَلْ تَرَى لَهُمْ مِنْ بَاقِيَةٍ. Do you see any remnants of them? Only their ruins. So after all of this life was beautified in their eyes, and they have that might and everything they needed, and all the tribes and nations around them were under their authority, this wind came and destroyed them. And Allah spoke about it as a punishment for what? لِنُذِيقَهُمْ عَذَابَ الْخِزْيِ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا, as in chapter 41 verse 16, so that we let them taste from this humiliation in this life. وَلَعَذَابُ الْآخِرَةِ أَخْزَى وَهُمْ لَا يُنصَرُونَ. And the torment that will await them in the hereafter is more severe and more humiliating, and they will never be victorious. وَأُتْبِعُوا فِي هَذِهِ الدُّنْيَا لَعْنَةً وَيَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أَلَا إِنَّ عَادًا كَفَرُوا رَبَّهُمْ أَلَا بُعْدًا لِعَادٍ قَوْمِ هُودٍ. And they were followed by a curse in this life, and also that will come in the hereafter. The people of Ad rejected their Lord Allah. أَلَا بُعْدًا لِعَادٍ قَوْمِ هُودٍ. Chapter 11 verse 60. Verily Ad disbelieved in their Lord, so away with Ad the people of Hud. Then Allah said, إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَةٌ. In this there is a sign and a proof and evidence for the complete ability of Allah, as well as for the honoring of Allah for His Messenger and for His Messengers and their followers, and that Allah is victorious, giving them victory in this life and on the day of resurrection. And that by itself as a reminder that the evil's consequences are not left without punishment in this life, and that what is awaiting that in the hereafter is even more severe. This is the story of Hud, but I want to add also further, something further here. And this is something more recent concerning this verse. In Newsweek magazine of the February 17, 1999 issue, page 38, there was an article about the city that was built by the people of Ad, known as Iram. Once they discover an ancient site, scientists examine everything they can put their hands on, and this is done in order to determine as closely as possible the period in history in which the city was built. No one thinks that the city found itself or it was founded due to some natural causes. People believe that it was built by the action of man, because nothing cannot cause the existence of anything. Now, using satellite maps and modern technology, a group of archaeologists discovered an ancient city in Oman, which is the southern part of Arabia. Nicholas Clapp, who documented a film about the expedition, said in this Newsweek's article cited, you know what this the Newsweek article title was? The Quran describes how the earth swallowed up a sumptuous but decadent city of towers called Iram. So Nicholas Clapp, who documented a film about the expedition, said in the Newsweek article cited, diggers can already see that the city center collapsed as told in the Quran, because it was built over a limestone cavern used to store water. End of quote. Allah in the Quran tells us the story of this magnificent city for the people of Ad, which is referred to by this Newsweek article. Allah says in Surah Al-Fajr, chapter 89, verse 6 and 8. Brother Small Kindness, if you can put it. Chapter 89, verse 6 and 8. أَلَمْ تَرَ كَيْفَ فَعَلَ رَبُّكَ بِعَاد إِرَمَ ذَاتِ الْعِمَادِ الَّتِي لَمْ يُخْلَقْ مِثْلُهَا فِي الْبِلَادِ. Or did you not consider how your Lord dealt with the Ad people, who had buildings with lofty pillars, the like of which were not produced in the land? Allah sent them the messenger Hud, calling them to the worship of Allah alone, but they rejected. And from the benefits, the fruits or the benefits from this story, first of all, that there is a commonality. There is a commonality between all the messengers, and that is one single message to their nations, to their respective nations: worship none but Allah. And also there is a particular benefit here in the sense that Allah by His wisdom tells us the story of some neighboring nations to Mecca. You know, this region is very close to Mecca, and that's where Islam in its final revelation came to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, was sent upon him. So in this respect it was really close for the people to remember, and Allah mentioned it also, and there was therefore a benefit for the Arabs in Mecca and for the believers also who accepted Islam to benefit from the story of things that are close to them. They speak their language, they know of them, much in common between them, and therefore this is easier for people to relate to. And from this one takes the following benefit, that reminding people by that which is closer to their understanding and fitting to their situation, and that this is from the etiquettes of spreading knowledge, and this is also this is deducted from this situation with the people of Ad. Alaykum as-salam wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. Also from the benefit that having these residences, these lofty places, these palaces, these decorations, and yet oppressing the slaves is nothing but injustice, which is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not condone and or like. Allah reminds them saying, أتبنون بكل ريع آية تعبثون وتتخذون مصانع لعلكم تخلدون. Do you build high palaces on every high place while you don't live in them, and you get yourselves palaces, fine buildings, as if you will live therein forever? So having these palaces, these fortresses, and these residences, either they could be taken for need, if they are needed. So they are generally permitted, but it depends on the intention of their users. So these buildings could be fortresses to defend against, for example, the enemies. And in this way, they will be useful. And this would be considered part of the jihad in the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Or they could be done for the sake of haughtiness, arrogance, oppression, and extravagance. And this is something disliked by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Another lesson from this is that no matter how this intelligence of the human being brings forth from this magnificent effects in the land and the buildings and so forth, yet it would be nothing of a benefit if it is not linked with belief to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His messengers. So the consequences are terrible. Allah speaks about the people of Ad, وَلَقَدْ مَكَّنَّاهُمْ فِي مَا إِن مَكَّنَّاكُمْ فِيهِ وَجَعَلْنَا لَهُمْ سَمْعًا وَأَبْصَارًا وَأَفْئِدَةً فَمَا أَغْنَى عَنْهُمْ سَمْعُهُمْ وَلَا أَبْصَارُهُمْ وَلَا أَفْئِدَتُهُمْ مِنْ شَيْءٍ إِذْ كَانُوا يَجْحَدُونَ بِآيَاتِ اللَّهِ وَحَاقَ بِهِمْ مَا كَانُوا بِهِ يَسْتَحْزِئُونَ. Surah Al-Ahqaf 46:26. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the translation of the meaning, and indeed we had firmly established them that wherewith we have not established you, O Quraysh, and we had assigned them the faculties of hearing, ears, seeing, eyes, and hearts, but their hearing, their ears, seeing, eyes, and their hearts availed them nothing, since they used to deny Allah's prophets and the prophethood and the evidences and the signs and the revelation of Allah, and they were completely encircled by that which they used to mock at. So this doesn't benefit them, no much how they are intelligent. Allah says also in Surah Al-An'am, فَلَمَّا نَسُوا مَا ذُكِّرُوا بِهِ فَتَحْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ أَبْوَابَ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ حَتَّى إِذَا فَرِحُوا بِمَا أُوتُوا أَخَذْنَاهُمْ بَغْتَةً فَإِذَا هُمْ مُبْلِسُونَ. In Surah Al-An'am, which is Surah 6 verse 44, chapter 6 verse 44, so when they forgot the warning with which they had been reminded, we opened for them the gates of every pleasant thing. And this is called istidraj. This is called istidraj, meaning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, allures them, giving them more, yet they are in a state of disobedience, and He gives them more. So when they forgot the warning which they had been reminded, we opened for them the gates of every pleasant thing, until in the midst of their enjoyment in that which they were given, all of the sudden, we took them in punishment, and lo, they were plunged into destruction with deep regrets and sorrows. And in the story of Ad and its people is also something relevant to our times. Those nations who think of themselves to be the strongest on earth, and practicing all this arrogance, you know, Ad is not far from them, because Ad's strength in its time were the most strength or most mighty in their time. So the matter is only relevant. And also we can see that the istidraj of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the alluring, gives them and gives them more and gives them more. But when the punishment of Allah takes them, Allah will seize them and they will be totally destroyed. And in this there is lessons for all of these nations, past and in present. This brings the end of the story of Prophet Hud alayhi salam. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it a benefit for myself and for all of you, and to make of these lessons something applicable in our lives. Wa sallallahu ala Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. If you have any question, please.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Everybody, جزاك الله خير for the fairness. If anybody have a question about the three topics which Brother Fairness has discussed this evening, please raise your hand and ask your question. السلام عليكم Brother Small Kindness. I see it's still a small kindness. Let's pray to you. Sister Steve and everybody, take the mic.
As-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Thank you, brother. It's very nice to see a room like this. I'm sure the West needs something in order to understand the proximity of Islam. And it has been detached relationships between the Muslim community and the Western community have gone back at least 10 years, I say, after the recent events. And it is up to us to try to fill that patch and inshallah keep a better understanding of Islam. Now, I've joined the room as you've probably seen. I was just wondering, what was the objection? Two words. The topic itself, for which you said that was the support, please.
Brother Kyle 90, Jazakallah khair for being here. Yes, this is a discussion on of the stories of the prophets and messengers, and we relate the story and then we start discussing some of the matters and the benefits in that story. And I am basing my discussions on an excellent book in this respect. It's called Qasas al-Anbiya, the stories of the prophets, by one of the renowned scholars of our times who died almost 50 years ago. And he is also a mufassir, and his name is Abdul Rahman al-Sa'di, al-Sheikh Abdul Rahman al-Sa'di rahimahullah ta'ala. And this is an excellent book of his, and I'm basing it for using it as a reference for my discussions here. We finished the story of Adam, and secondly the story of Noah, and then thirdly this was the story of Prophet Hud. Brother Abu Maher, I think you still have a question. Okay, wa alaykum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
I haven't was really linked to kind of the when a person dies and he goes into Barzakh, are the seven heavens connected with it, or is it a separate entity altogether?
Lost my room. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. Sister, inspire me. Where is the brother here? He was breaking and I couldn't hear much of... and then he spoke in the language which wasn't really clear. Brother Abu Maher. Brother Abu Maher, wa iyakum. What was the question related to the earth?